Hello, Gavin, Hoey here. Now, if you saw my last video where I was in Florence reviewing the little mini gorillapod tripod thing, you saw me take this picture of Florence at night. So I thought I'd show you how I processed it inside of Photoshop. Now, of course, I was shooting in RAW, so that means I'm using Adobe Camera RAW to process the image. Let's start with colour. Now, it was mixed lighting, so I used auto white balance in camera. But of course, in RAW, white balance doesn't matter because I can drop to the white balance list and change it to tungsten to get the tungsten colour. Or I can change it to fluorescent. And actually, I often prefer the fluorescent white balance to the tungsten on night shots. Now, it looks perhaps just a tiny bit pink. So let's take away a little bit of the pink by moving the slider like that. Okay, so colour-wise, I think I'm in the right sort of area now. Let's go down to exposure. Does the image look like it needs any more exposure? Yeah, I think it probably could do with a bit of an improvement. So I'm going to take the exposure up maybe half a stop or so, something like that. That should just make life a little bit brighter on the overall exposure. Now, it is looking a little bit burnt out on these highlights, on these lights. If I zoom in over there, you'll see what I mean. Streetlights very difficult when you have them in a nighttime shot because a 4 second exposure like this means that they completely burn out. Now we can try bringing some detail back with recovery, but it's never going to do the whole job even if I take it up to maximum. So let's put it somewhere around about the middle so we get some assistance. Okay, let's fit that back onto the screen. Next thing I'm going to do is to try and bring up the contrast a little bit because it looks slightly flat. So I'm going to take the contrast slider and just take that along a reasonable amount, not too far. I'm going to do the same with the clarity, which increases contrast on the midtones, and that often actually works pretty well. So we're looking pretty good. I'm kind of happy with that. But down at the bottom, we have vibrance and saturation, where we started with color. So let's see if we can finish this bit with color. So I'm going to put a bit of saturation in there just so we get a baseline of color. And then I can increase the vibrance, not go too far because it kind of looks a little bit sort of over the top and wahey and yeah, really not good there at all. So a little bit of vibrance round about the 40 to 50 area, something like that should just give me that punch of colour that I'm looking for. And as we zoomed in, you can actually see how sharp this image was. 4 seconds on a quite a springy little gorillapod, nonetheless, nice sharp shot. Okay, so kind of happy with the picture as it stands. Couple of things we can do to improve it. We're working in Photoshop CS4, but you can do this in CS5 or even Lightroom 2 and 3. You have this little tool up here, the graduated filter. So I can choose an exposure, for example, let's put -1 stop. And I can drag a stop of exposure just down in the sky, just like that. So that'll put a little tiny dark patch up there. And I can repeat that along the bottom as well, so we have a little bit of darkness into the water as well. Simple reason being is I want really the eye to go in towards this part here. This is the nice bit of the image. Okay, worth a check as well, because we've shot in RAW, let's go in really close and we'll have a look and see if there's any noise, which of course there is a little tiny bit. So I'm going to jump to the detail tab and I'm going to take the luminance slider and just bring this up just a wee bit. Fortunately, I was shooting at 200 ISO, so there's not too much noise in there, but a little bit of noise reduction is always a good idea. Okay, so there we are. That's the image completed. We can open that image, come out of RAW, and move into Photoshop. And really, I don't need to do anything else to the image, but as I'm here, I'll just open an action, and I'll play one of my own little actions that I've made ages ago, just for adding in this nice little white border, and that finishes the whole effect off. So there we are, that's how we go from the as shot image to the final image that you saw in the video. I'm Gavin Hoey, thanks for watching.